As if it couldn't get any worse, more scary news out of Japan. It's been almost 5 months now since the tsunami damaged the Fukushima nuclear reactors. But after countless reassurances of safety, they've now detected lethal radiation levels in the plant, capable of killing a person within a few seconds of exposure. So what lies ahead? We welcome back Michio Kaku, author of the book Physics of the Future and professor of theoretical physics at the City University of New York. Where I went, the University of New York. I went there. So listen, thank you very much for joining us. Is this new, or have they been measuring the radiation wrong all along?
This is a leftover from the original accident. Remember, we had multiple hydrogen gas explosions which blew the roof off these reactors? Well, as a consequence, it contaminated the ventilation shafts. But cleanup has been very slow. They haven't even really begun cleaning up the operation. It's not stable yet. Maybe next year it'll be stable. So that's where they're picking up these hot spots.
What does it mean for the cleanup efforts? I mean, you said it's not stable. Workers, can they even go in there now?
A few seconds, you're going to get several million times normal dose of radiation. It's a horrible death. Radiation burns over your body, hair falls out, multiple organ failure, nausea. You don't want workers to go there at all. And so, this is inevitably going to impede cleanup operation because there could be other hot spots.
That means, no, they can't go in, basically. They can't clean it up, is
what you're
saying.
They can't go into these areas. However, they can still clean up the bulk of the damage to the reactors. Mm-hmm. But the ventilation shaft, you got to stay away. It's no man's land.
I want to ask you this. Is this a job that a human has to do? Can some sort of robot possibly go in and do this work?
You've seen the robots there. They're pathetic. They're almost like toys, computers on treads with little TV camera, with a joystick controlling them. It's pretty sad.
If they had more sophisticated ones, then...
We don't really have sophisticated robots that are automatons that can make repairs and turn screwdrivers and stuff like that. Okay. That's beyond our capability.
We're talking decades here before?
Hitachi Corporation estimated 30 years to clean up. Gosh. In other words, perhaps up to 50 years. Three Mile Island took 14 years to clean up. Chernobyl, after 25 years, is still not cleaned up. It's still melting into the ground.
It's kind of hard to keep track of where the radiation has been found. They've detected the radiation in the water, in the seafood, the beef, and the dairy, but now they're testing rice for radiation. So what does that mean for the food supply there?
Rice and also tea leaves. We're talking about radiation sailing 200 miles from the site, and Tokyo is only 150 miles from the site. Now, to be sure, radiation levels are still low. Radiation levels at site, of course, means that the food has to be impounded, but it does mean that you have to exercise caution, and people are buying decimeters and Geiger counters on their own.
Yeah.
They don't trust the utilities figures anymore.
That's what I was going to ask you. Remember the beginning when TEPCO was giving out these numbers and the IAEA and people here in the United States said, oh, we're not so sure about that if they were giving us the numbers. Can the people there be sure of it? I guess they feel that they can't.
Yeah, they feel that you cannot trust the utility. Either they were incompetent during the whole accident or they were lying during the whole accident. We physicists in the United States, we use our computer models. We knew what was happening more than what they were saying. And we know they were lowballing, giving low estimates of the radiation damage because we could simulate the accident with our computers independently.
With all the plants shut down, what was it like for people for comfort there? For the average person, were they able to get the electricity they needed, the air conditioning, or whatever they needed?
People in Tokyo are melting right now. The government has
said... Hot summer, yeah.
Yeah, the government has said that everyone has a patriotic duty to reduce electricity consumption by 20%. Now, try that in the United States. If everyone had to turn down their air conditioning by 20%, you'd have a revolt in this country, right? And that's the kind of sacrifice that the Japanese people are undergoing right now. Massive restructuring of the energy structure of the country.
So we talked about TEPCO. What about the government? Can the people of Japan trust what the government is saying about this?
Well, even the government was given incorrect numbers by TEPCO. And the government right now, by the way, is looking at alternatives. Perhaps natural gas, perhaps fossil fuels, more conservation. None of the above look very attractive at all for the future.
I don't think that... Did they realize the damage and the repercussions of this? And because I'm wondering, maybe they didn't. Let's just give them the benefit of the doubt. Maybe they didn't know what the readings would be and they were reading them wrong. Is there a lesson in it, not only for Japan and for the United States, but for the rest of the world when it comes to this type of energy?
There's a big lesson. President Obama right now has to make huge decisions about the future of nuclear energy in this country. Germany, Switzerland have thrown in the towel. No more nuclear power plants. They're going to be phased out. Italy is now tottering. And so the question is, what will the United States do? That's going to be the big question, because people are wondering about the next 10 years.
Getting off of fossil fuels and all of that. And of course, it would be one of those things would be nuclear energy, correct?
That's right. And remember that President Barack Obama canceled the nuclear waste dump in Yucca Mountain. So even if we build more nuclear power plants, there's no place to put the nuclear waste.
Very interesting. I could sit here. I wish you'd stay after the show and let's talk for a couple minutes. I love it. Thank you, Michio Kaku. Thank you for joining us tonight.